Hey guys, you're probably here because you want to know all about the signs and symptoms of type 2 diabetes. Well, I'm going to give you all of that information. We're going to go through the signs and symptoms, we're going to go through the risk factors and when to seek medical advice. This is going to be quite a long video, so if at any point you want any specific information, feel free to click on that description below. I've timestamped it, find the relevant information you want and click on it, or just watch the full video. Now let's begin. Okay, so first of all, what is type 2 diabetes? Let's keep it short and simple. Type 2 diabetes is quite commonly associated with obesity, and to keep it short, type 2 diabetes is when your body is unable to regulate all of the sugar that's in your body, in your blood. It's unable to regulate it properly and it's unable to use all of it as fuel. And the main cause of this is when the pancreas begins to produce less insulin, or your insulin is just no longer as effective. It's no longer effective enough to put all of that sugar into your cells because there's so much sugar and it's finding it difficult to regulate all of that sugar in the blood. Now the problem with type 2 diabetes is there's too much sugar floating around in your blood all over your body, and this can result in devastating consequences. So for example, it can increase your risk of heart attacks, it can increase your risk of strokes, it can increase your risk of certain types of cancers, it can even cause vision loss, it can cause nerve damage and even kidney damage. And the list does go on, by the way, I'm just summarizing some of the main ones. Now type 2 diabetes is more common in older adults, however the stats are changing with time as more younger people are becoming overweight and obese, and type 2 diabetes is actually increasing in younger people as a result of this. Now, if you do want more information on type 2 diabetes or type 1 diabetes, I am going to leave some really useful links in the description below. So if you're interested, feel free to check it out. Now, here in the UK, more than 4.8 million people have diabetes, and that's 1 in 14 people. And every 2 minutes, one person is diagnosed with diabetes. So as you can see, it's a very large number. Now what's even scarier is that more people are at risk of diabetes than have ever been before. And this is increasing, this trend is increasing. And the reason for it is the lifestyles that people are living, obesity is on the rise, people are eating less healthy food, they're doing less exercise, so it's putting them at a much higher risk of type 2 diabetes, which is scary stuff. So in general, the more weight we put on, the more overweight we become, the more obese we become, the higher risk we are of getting type 2 diabetes, which puts us at risk of all those other things that we spoke about earlier in the video. Now, let's talk about those signs and symptoms. Let's crack on. So to begin with, the signs and symptoms of type 2 diabetes can be quite challenging to spot, as early signs are not always noticeable. Also, many people sometimes don't have the symptoms and it can go undiagnosed for many years. And these symptoms can develop slowly, so it's super important that you learn them so you can easily recognize them and speak to your healthcare professional. That's the most important thing. If you have any of these sort of symptoms that we're talking about in today's video, please make an appointment to speak to your healthcare professional. Now let's begin. So sign and symptom number one, frequent urination. So you need to go to the toilet quite often to go and pee. Now, in the medical world, we call this polyuria. Poly means many, multiple. Urea means urinating, okay? So the reason for this is when you have type 2 diabetes, your sugar levels are high. We spoke about this earlier, there's more sugar in your blood, and your kidneys are constantly trying to filter all this sugar out. Now this filtering is going to make you need to go and pee more often. Now moving on to sign and symptom number two, almost always associated with frequent urination is the feeling of feeling more thirsty. Now because of the frequent urination that's needed to remove the sugar from the blood, this can result in the body losing more water than usual, and over time this can cause dehydration and lead to you feeling more thirsty than usual. Moving on to sign and symptom number three, always feeling hungry. Now this is because people with type 2 diabetes often don't get enough energy from the food that they've eaten. Now the reason for this is the digestive system breaks down the food into simple sugars called glucose. This is used as a fuel in the body, however for people with type 2 diabetes, not enough of this sugar moves around the bloodstream and gets into the body cells. Because of this, people with type 2 diabetes often feel constantly hungry. So those are the first three symptoms that I want you to remember. These are usually the most early symptoms that you'll get with type 2 diabetes. However, people are different, but these are usually the top three. We call them the three P's in the medical world, so polydipsia, polyuria, and polyphagia. And these three P's can be a really good simple indicator that your sugar levels might be a little too high. So the best thing to do if you have any of these three P's, speak to your healthcare professional, speak to them, get an appointment so they can check you out and examine you and do a blood test and do whatever they want to do. Now moving on from the three P's, there are are other symptoms as well that are associated with type 2 diabetes. They are not as common as the three P's, but we're still gonna work through them. So let's begin. So let's begin with feeling very tired. And I'm talking about feeling very tired all the time, wanting to go for a nap, just feeling really sleepy all the time. This can sometimes be a sign that your sugar levels are a bit high. Similar to how we spoke about feeling hungry all the time, because your body's not able to utilize all that energy properly and get that sugar into your cells, you're gonna feel tired. Another sign that I want to discuss is blurred vision. Look, if your sugar levels are actually really high, they can damage little tiny blood vessels in your eyes, and this can cause your vision to get blurry and a change in your vision, like a blurred vision. Anything like that, you need to speak to your optometrist or speak to your healthcare professional so they can check it out, they can examine you and find out what is going on. This is a really good sign to be aware of. And it's important to remember that if the blood sugar levels remain uncontrolled, this can result in visual loss, okay? So it is super important if you have any blurred vision that you keep an eye on it and you speak to your healthcare professional if you notice it. The next thing that I want to talk about, again, isn't very common because a lot of patients don't really notice it, but that is slow healing wounds. So if you've had a wound, if you've had a cut, and you feel like it's taking a long time to heal, more than a week, more than 2 weeks, it takes you to a long time for you to heal from any cuts or any braces or anything like that, this could be a sign that your sugar levels are too high. The problem is, when your sugar levels are high in your blood, it can be very difficult for your body to heal any sort of wounds like that. The sugar makes it very difficult. Moving on to the next sign and symptom, a tingling, a numbness in your hands and feet. Remember, those high sugar levels can also attach to your nerve cells. They attach to the end of them and they kind of block the transmission between each other. Now, that blockage is what causes this numbness, that tingling sensation. So if you're suffering from anything like that, you need to speak to your healthcare professional. The next sign and symptom I'd like to discuss is itchy skin and also associated with fungal infections. If you're constantly getting itchy fungal infection type skin conditions, for example, under the breasts, in the groin area, where skin folds basically and it's moist and warm, and you're constantly getting these infections, this can sometimes be a sign that your sugar levels are too high and it's causing these yeast infections to occur. So if it's happening all the time, if you haven't spoke to your healthcare professional about it and you're just self-treating at home, then please make an appointment to speak to your healthcare professional. And the final sign that I'd like you to look out for is a sudden weight loss or a loss of your muscle mass loss, we call it. This is again linked to that lack of blood sugar going into the cells properly. This can sometimes happen as a result of when your sugar levels are too high. So if you notice anything like this, and if you've got any of the other symptoms of diabetes as well, you should speak to your healthcare professional. And noted, by the way, if you ever have any sort of weight loss out of the ordinary, you're not trying to lose weight, please, please, please speak to your healthcare professional urgently. Now, one thing that I'd just like to quickly mention, just by having one of these symptoms, it's not a surefire diagnosis that you've got type 2 diabetes, so please don't worry, please don't be afraid. But the important thing is that you look out for them, you keep an eye out for them. If you have any of these sort of symptoms, that you speak to your healthcare professional so they can examine you, do the relevant tests, do everything that's needed to make sure that you're okay, okay? It might be that you don't have type 2 diabetes, but the important thing is that you know these signs and symptoms and you know, right, I've got one of these symptoms, I need to go and speak to my healthcare professional. That is the most important thing, because your health is the most important thing. So now that we know the signs and symptoms of type 2 diabetes for you to be aware of, the next thing I want to talk about is risk factors. So what puts you at a higher risk of getting type 2 diabetes? Now, there's quite a lot of them. I'm going to leave it over here for you. All the information is going to pop up. So please make sure to pause the screen, give it a quick read if you don't manage to read it whilst I'm waffling on, okay? Or if you want more information on it as well, I am going to leave it in the description below as well. So please do read it, because certain risk factors can put you obviously at a higher risk of getting type 2 diabetes. And there are changes that you can make as well to reduce those risks. So to summarize, please remember, if you have any of the signs and symptoms mentioned in this video, please make an appointment to speak to your healthcare professional. Look at those risk factors as well. If you don't have any of these signs and symptoms, that's great. Look at those risk factors though and see what changes you can make as well, because there's loads of changes that we can all make to reduce our risk of type 2 diabetes. Remember, as I said earlier in the video, the risk of type 2 diabetes is increasing, and there's lots of things that we can do, for example, losing weight, eating more healthy, exercising, all these little things that we can do to help reduce our risk of type 2 diabetes. If you are interested in losing weight, I have quite a few videos on them. I will leave links to them in the description below and up here. And if you want more information on reducing risk factors, I'm going to leave more information in the description below. That, my friends, is the end of this week's video. Thank you for watching. I hope you now know everything you need to know about the signs and symptoms of type 2 diabetes, the risk factors, what it is, and what to do about it. Always remember you're awesome, and I will see you next week. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.